Good morning, everyone. This is Steve Place from investingwithoptions.com, and I did say good morning. This is a special pre-market episode where I decide to get up early enough to do one. It's going to be a fun trading session, especially if you're delta negative, as there's been a major sell-off in the Asian and European markets, and it looks like it has spilled over into the American session already. European markets are down 7-8%, with the DAX leading the way. Japan finished down nearly 10% on the Nikkei, and the Hang Seng is off 8.3%. And once again, we have another bang-up headline from the guys at Yahoo Finance. We have stocks head for sharp decline on recession fears. That's a brilliant headline, guys. You didn't think that these recession fears haven't existed until today? This is a great example of what happens when you try and equate market noise to rational fundamental thought. They just need to quit trying to explain price action and say stocks are down because more people were selling than buying. It's a much simpler explanation, and it saves a lot of trouble for everyone else. And as far as I can tell, the ES futures hit their circuit breaker levels, and I think the Dow Mini did as well, but we do need to look at where we are relative to the past couple days. We're going to zoom out to the 1 hour right here. The circuit breakers hit potential support as we were hitting our circuit breaker from the lows of yesterday. And so while everyone's saying we're off so much, we're only near the lows of yesterday. But everyone probably will panic, and we're most likely going to break lower from the bottom that everyone has been calling. OPEC did cut, but the overall strength in the dollar has been hurting commodities. Crude is off 7% now, and gold is down nearly 3%. Corporate bonds aren't faring well either, and the yields on Treasury are getting frothy, almost bubble-like, as the rush for safety has driven demand for safe assets through the roof. And as for my book, yesterday I did make a call to sell call verticals in SKF, and it looks like it was poor timing in hindsight, but I had already had a bullish vertical put on. I did have a bullish vertical put on already, so if we go to our analyze tab, I already have it pulled up. It theoretically was a risk-free trade, but due to my bad trade execution and some slippage, it is a $50 risk and a 450 gain, so that's a 9x risk reward with a break even at 140 and 200. It's a nice wide range that the double short probably will settle into for expiration, so I'm just going to let that one simmer. And into this market weakness, I will get more dollar bearish, which means bullish commodity equities like oil companies and gold miners, while hedging against the market to reduce my portfolio exposure. And I will be getting into more bullish verticals with SKF, SRS, SMN as well. And once these do go down, and they most likely will, I will get into some more risk-free iron condors with nice wide spreads. And we're getting back to certain levels in certain equities where it might be a good idea to start selling puts against, only if you want to buy the stock at the strike. Coke comes to mind, Johnson & Johnson, Pfizer, a lot of the blue chip names that do have dividends where you can buy, and you can go ahead and sell calls against 6 months out. I did mention that in a video a couple days ago. Selling puts just as a bullish trade is dumb, because unless you're willing to put the capital up to buy and hold for a couple months more, you shouldn't be doing them as well. Even though you do see that volatility is high, you can still lose money on these. And that's all I've got for now. I'm probably going to go back to sleep now. I hope you guys do have a great day with whatever you're doing. My name is Steve Place. I'm with investingwithoptions.com. Enhance returns, reduce risk, and print money.